Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here, and today we're going to show you how to program a Honeywell 5811 door or window contact to our 2GB Go control panel. So, you may say, how are you going to program a Honeywell device to a 2GB system? The beauty of a 2GB Go control is that it will work with 2GB sensors. If you've seen any of our 2GB sensor programming videos, we show you how to program DW10s and all the various door sensors that 2GB offers. But if you have existing Honeywell sensors in your house, or if you like the style or the range or the functionality of a 5811 or any other Honeywell wireless sensor, without doing anything to this system, the built-in wireless receiver will allow you to use any Honeywell 5800 series wireless device. So we're going to go ahead and program our 5811 to the panel. We hit the home button. We can either do security menu toolbox or the shortcut hotkey of Go control. And then we're typing our installer code, which is default 1561. Now we're into programming. If we hit system configuration, we're asking for the RF sensor number. Any 2GB Go control will allow you to do up to 48 wireless zones. Typically, each wireless device will take up a zone. So we haven't programmed any yet to this system. We're going to use zone number 1, and you can see Q1 is select RF sensor number, and then at the bottom in the white line, it's telling you which wireless device do you want to program, or which wireless slot do you want to use. We're going to use slot number 1, so we hit the down arrow, and now we're on the sensor 1 type. If you've used the Honeywell systems, this is your response type, your response type setting, which is basically entry exit 1 or perimeter or whatever you're going to do. And the way you program that will affect how this sensor works and how it communicates and operates this system. So this we're going to put on our front door. Our front door happens to be a door that we use when we come and go from the house. So the option we would want to choose is exit/entry 1. And what that option means is we're going to get a 30-second entry delay when the system is armed and this door opens. We have 30 seconds to get to the keypad and disarm the system. When we arm the system to leave and the door is closed, we have 60 seconds to then open and close the door. As long as the door is closed by the time the 60-second exit delay period has not run out yet, then we're not going to have any false alarms. If this was on a back door that we don't use when the system is armed, or if it was on a window, you would want to choose perimeter for the sensor type. We do have a list of sensor types on our website, so if you're ever wondering which sensor type to use, you can see a descriptor of how each different sensor type will react. But again, with any door or window sensor, really its option is exit entry 1 or perimeter. So we lock that selection in and we go to RF sensor 1 equipment code. This screen, it's not a critical question, but we do like to tell the Go control as close as we can the exact type of sensor we're using with this zone. So if we hit the right arrow, it'll scroll through the options, and because it's not a 2GB device, we want to scroll past all the 2GB stuff, and we can get to Honeywell D/W5816. You may say, well, it's not a 5816, it's a 5811, so why would you choose that? Unfortunately, when they input all these different equipment codes, they didn't have 5811 available at the time, so we're just going to go ahead and choose 5816. It's not exactly what it is. You could also do existing door and window contact if you wanted. Again, it's not going to affect how the system really works. For me, if you do 5816, it's not a 5816, it's kind of not really the right information. So we're going to just choose existing door window contact. We hit the down arrow, and now we're asked to enter the serial number. Just like any Honeywell device, there is a sticker both on the back, and if we were to open it on the inside, with an A for alpha followed by 3-digit number. We could go ahead and type that number in. Or if we clear that out, if we hit shift followed by learn, it's waiting for a sensor transmission. On a Honeywell system, you got to transmit that 3 times to lock it in. With the 2GB, you just got to do it once. It knows it's a Honeywell device, it shows the transmission ID or the serial number, and it does match with the serial number on the sticker. If we hit OK, Then we can hit the down arrow to advance, and they're asking for the equipment age. If this is a brand new 5811, leave it new. If this is an existing 5811 that was in the house from an old Honeywell wireless system, you could scroll over to existing. In this case, it's a brand new sensor. We're gonna hit the down arrow. It learned in the proper loop number. If we had a 5816, which uses the external read contact option or the magnet with the sensor, you could actually choose loop number one or two. When you do the auto enroll, it should auto learn in the proper loop. On a 5811, loop number one is the only loop to use, so we lock that in with a down arrow press. Now we have our dial delay. This question is asking us, when this 5811 sets off an alarm and the panel goes into alarm mode, will the panel send that message to a central station right away, or will it hold that message for a program dial delay period so that if we made a mistake as the end user, we could cancel the alarm with a disarm? When monitored with alarm grid, we always recommend that you disable your dial delay. We do a really good job of avoiding false alarms with our central station, with the way that we call you and try to contact multiple numbers before we dispatch the police. So we always like to get as much information to the operators as we can immediately, and then let them do their job of verifying if it's a false alarm or not. So we're going to encourage you to go ahead and disable this, but if you wanted it enabled, you could leave it there. Now we're on the voice descriptor field. Just like with any 2 gig wireless programming, you have to tell the zone what it is, so that instead of remembering zone number one is my 5811 at my front door, I would just visibly see it here, and if I have voice chimes on, it will actually say front door. So instead of typing on a keypad, it's a sequence of choosing words from a preset library. Each word equates to a 3-digit number. This list is on the back of our 2 gig Go Control quick programming guide. We also have this information on our website, and if we look at the list, it's alphabetical, and front is 098. So first you hit insert, that puts the first word in, it just jumps to the first word in the list, and if we then type 098, it switches to front. If we hit insert again, it puts another word, again, goes to the very top of the list for abort, and if we scroll down the page, we can see door is 058, and now we have a nice clear descriptor, front door. If we hit the down arrow, we're to the next screen where it asks sensor one reports, enabled or disabled. Reports is dealing with central station monitoring. So if your system is monitored and you want the alarms from this device to go to the central station, you're going to want to have this option enabled. So we're going to leave that as is because this system is monitored. And now we're on the supervised question. Supervised is just like with a Honeywell system. It's supervising low battery alerts from the detector, and also range issues from the 5811. So if your 5811 was in use for a long time and the battery started to get low, this panel is constantly and periodically checking, or consistently and periodically checking, status of this device. Is the battery voltage good, and is it in range of the panel? If the battery is good, it's okay, but if it doesn't see this device because it's too far away, you could see a supervision loss issue, and then you would know you may have a range issue. So we always want to supervise our protected zone so that we know in advance about issues before it's too late and we've had a break-in and the sensor didn't work and now we're left to wonder, oh, well, it was a low battery issue. Why didn't I know about that in advance? That would be if you had it disabled. With it enabled, you'll know about those events when you have some time to fix the event before it's a problem. So we hit the down arrow to lock that in, and now we're on the chime question. With most door contacts, we set up with a chime so that when the system is disarmed and the door opens, the system can actually give us an indication, audible, either a voice enunciation or a beep or both. So there's various options for chime. You have voice only, ding dong with voice, ding dong two, no voice, ding dong with voice two. So there's a lot of different options. We're gonna go ahead and choose ding dong with voice. So we'll get a nice beep beep plus front door when this door opens. If we hit the down arrow, we're on a summary screen and we can review our programming. We're using entry exit one because it is a door that we use when the system is armed. So therefore it needs to be on delay to enter and exit the home. We are calling it an existing door window sensor because we didn't have the option to choose a more descriptive 5811 device type. We have our valid serial number. We have that it's a brand new device. We have loop number one. We have our dial delay disabled, so alarms from this detector will go immediately to the central station. We're calling it front door. We have reports enabled because our system is monitored. We want alarms from this device to go to our central station. And finally, we have supervision enabled, so we know about low battery and range issues in advance. And we have our chime for ding dong with voice. If we hit skip and end, we have a summary screen for all of the system programming. We didn't make any other changes, so there's really nothing to review here. We simply hit exit to lock in our settings. You'll notice the screen goes dark. The system is literally rebooting itself. Anytime you're in programming on a 2GIG Go control, and you come out of programming after making a change and saving a change, the system does reboot. And this is just to lock in the settings. You can hear it say disarm, ready to arm after a few seconds, and a few more seconds go by, we're back to our system ready, not armed status screen showing that the zone is happy. So once this was installed on the door, we can test it. If we open our door, the magnet's gonna pull away from the sensor. You could hear the ding dong chime noise. You could hear the voice enunciation of front door. The system goes from ready to not ready, and it shows front door open. So you get all kinds of status, audible and visual, to let you know your front door is open. You're not gonna be able to arm the system until the door is closed. And immediately that fault message goes away and we're ready to arm. And we have now verified that we have properly programmed our Honeywell 5811 wireless door and window sensor to our 2GIG Go control panel. We hope you've enjoyed this video. We invite you to subscribe to our channel. And if you have any questions on properly programming your 5811 sensor, please email support@alarmgrid.com.